Okay, Shalom. Shalom to the elect of the nation of Israel, the elect of Yahweh Shai. And once again, it's another video coming to you through the spirit and power of Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, Baal Shem Rekah Kodash. All praises and glories definitely due, especially in the times we're living in, which indeed is a blessing to know this truth, because this is our light. This is our guidance to Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai. Hopefully this video is edifying to you brothers and your few sisters that watch these videos. The subject matter will be this so-called Pastor Geno Jennings, which is he's a Hollywood freak show, okay? a sideshow clown. And by the end of this video, you'll see why I say that. Anyway, I was watching Elder Apostatar's video, the video here, Apostle Geno Jennings, because he calls himself an apostle. Geno Jennings took the bag. The Lord is not, it is right here, the Lord is not black.
Oh boy. Anyway, right. This is a response to Pop.
Elder Apostatar did a response to it, to a video, I guess the video the brother from Baltimore did. This is his video here. Pastor Geno Jennings say Yahweh Shai, well, he says Jesus, say Jesus was black, but what do I care? Hebrews don't love Jesus. Now, when I was watching Elder Apostatar's video, he mentioned that years ago, Geno Jennings had did a video, or rather did a lesson in his church and for his congregation. Now, I'm not sure if that was the title of the lesson, but the title of the video from which the video comes from the lesson. The title of the video is right here.
Rather, he was not.
And this video was done 4 years ago. The name of the video is Apostle Geno Jennings. Jesus is not a white man. False image of Jesus. So 4 years ago, now Elder Apostatar mentioned that in his video. So what I did was typed in Geno Jennings, Jesus is not a white man. And lo and behold, it led me to this video, which proved what Elder Apostatar said. Okay? And this was done about, it says 4 years ago here. So now, all of a sudden, and I'm going to play you the video that inspired Elder Apostatar to do his video. Now, all of a sudden, this guy is backpedaling Geno Jennings, which prompted Elder Apostatar to say that he took the bag. You know? So again, I'm not going to watch, this video. The title says it all. Apostle Geno Jennings, Jesus is not a white man. False image of Jesus. All right. So now, let's go to the video that inspired both the elder from Baltimore and Elder Apostatar to do their videos. Now, I'm going to go to Elder Apostatar's video, which was put up 3 hours ago. Apostle Geno Jennings took that bag. So let's check it out. I'm gonna play a little bit of it. Then I'm gonna go to the brother from Baltimore and play some of his video.
Oh boy. Anyway, this is a response to Apostle Geno Jennings, Hebrew Israelites, God is not black. Ain't that something? So I try to listen to some of this. Anyway, he says in the, he speaks about Daniel. He mentions all the scriptures that we go through, right? And mind you, this is a few years ago. I don't know, maybe 4 or 5 years ago. He did a video where he said that God is not a white man.
Now that's spot on, because I just showed you the video he did 4 years ago. All right, the video here, Jesus is not a white man. It was put up by Tony Harvin, all right, has 85,000 views. So what Elder Pastor said is spot on.
And I believe, I don't know if he said, well, God is actually black, but you have to be a damn fool, a damn retard, or paid off to say that these precepts, Revelation 1, 13, 15, Daniel 7, verse 9. You know, they're paying these motherfuckers off, man.
Yeah, that is true. They are paying them off. Let me bring in the scripture for you. All right, this is the book of Amos, the 5th chapter, and the 12th verse. And Yahweh Shem Yahushai sees that these guys are being, you know, that these guys are being paid off. They took the bag, because this is what the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, said to Amos the prophet. He said, "For I know your manifold transgressions and your mighty sins. They afflict the just." He's talking about the nation of Israel, which what's his face? The Hollywood freak show. Because that's what he reminds me of. He reminds me of a Hollywood actor. You know, that voice of his, I don't even think that's real. It reminds me of, and I think that's probably where he got the cue from. I mean, you know, the movie A Soldier Story, the character that, the character Sergeant Waters, which was played by, let me type it in, who played Sergeant Waters? Cesar, I think his name was. Who played Sergeant Waters in A Soldier Story? Yeah, this the guy right here. He kind of, Geno Jennings kind of looked like this guy, man. I think his name was Adolfo Cesar, man. There you go. That's the guy right there. Hey, they look like they could be brothers, right? Adolf Cesar. And the voice. Now, if you watched the movie A Soldier Story, the voice of that character sounds just like Geno Jennings. All right, that same voice. Okay. So that guy ain't nothing but a Hollywood sideshow. Anyway, Amos, the 5th chapter, 12th verse. "For I know your manifold transgressions and your mighty sins. They afflict the just. They take a bribe." All right, they take a bribe. So another thing too, we're not ignorant of that 501c3 tax statute. Y'all should Google that if you don't know too much about it. Google it. It's also known as a gag order, because it stops the churches from bringing out the full truth. Okay, it's a gag order, and it was created by when you go into the background of it, the 501c3, it was created by Lyndon Baines Johnson to stifle the churches from bringing out the full truth, or from bringing out the truth. Which the only ones that can bring out the full truth is the Lord's servants, his prophets. And the Lord's servants, his prophets, we were sent out into the streets. It tells you that in the book of Proverbs, the 1st chapter, "Wisdom crieth without, she uttereth her voice in the streets." The prophets of the Lord, they're not going to be in as a matter of fact, let's go to Let's bring out a couple of scriptures on that. They're not going to be in a building, even though Yahweh Shai went into the synagogue every now and then. But the true prophets of the Lord, they're not going to be huddled up in a building teaching. They're going to be out there on the streets teaching. That's where the real ministry is, out on the streets. In these streets, man. And we don't need a temple or a church, which the word church is from the Greek ekklesia, which means called out. The calling out is done on the streets. Now, the majority of the calling out now, because we're in a new age, is on the internet, in particular YouTube. But back in the day, the main ministry, the calling out, was out on the streets. That's a fact. 1 Corinthians, the 3rd chapter, 9th verse. For we are laborers together with the Heavenly Father. Ye are the Most High's husbandry. Those are the ones that's called and believe and have received the gift of faith. They're the Most High's husbandry. Now, what's a husbandry? Number one, what's a husband? A planter. When you look up the word husband, it means planter. So we're the Lord's planting. As a matter of fact, there's a scripture somewhere in Isaiah, the 61st chapter, is it? We're the Lord's planting. Okay, let's get that real quick. And there's another one that comes to mind, the one in Psalms, the 1st chapter. But let me get... bear with me for a minute. Isaiah 61, let's read that. The planting of the Lord. It is right here. I knew it was Isaiah 61. Isaiah 61 and 3. To appoint unto them that moan in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes. That's us, the hopeful elect. The oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Tell me we ain't in the spirit of heaviness. That they might be called trees of righteousness. So we those trees, man, planted. The planting of the Lord, that he might be glorified. That's why the scripture speaks about we are the Most High's husbandry. Now, if you know the meaning of your words, you would know, if you look it up in the etymology dictionary, you would know the word husband means planter. So we're the planting of the Lord. And you know what? That destroys these people that say, oh, you guys are bringing in this guy into your camp. You're bringing in. We don't bring nobody into the camp. Yahweh Hashem Yahshai brings people into the camp, and Yahweh Hashem Yahshai kicks out people out of the camp. Yahweh Hashem Yahshai brings into the camp, and Yahweh Hashem Yahshai kicks out of the camp. Okay? This thing of ours is totally spiritual. So again, let me go to the one in Psalms to double up on that. So that was Isaiah 61 and 3. Let's go to Psalms, the 1st chapter. Psalm 1 and 3. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. That's the Lord's elect, the hopeful elect, guys like us. The rivers of water. The rivers of water is a metaphor for this knowledge, this truth. It's like rivers of water. It keeps flowing, and you got to flow with it. Because if you don't, it'll just run right over you and keep on going. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. So there's the point. You know, we're like trees planted by the rivers of water. Planted by who? The husbandman, which is who? The Heavenly Father Yahweh through his Son Yahweh Shai. That's who. So again, 1 Corinthians 3 and 9, for we are laborers together with the Heavenly Father, that's us brothers in the faith. Ye are the Most High's husbandry. We're the planting of the Lord, Isaiah 61 and 3. Ye are the Most High's building. So we don't need a building. A lot of people ask us that. Where's your your church that we can come to and worship. No, we don't have no church. All right, a church as in a building. Our building is wherever we set up camp. That's our building. Now, back in the day, we used to have a building. Matter of fact, here in Connecticut, we used to have a school in Bridgeport, Connecticut. But eventually, the school had to be shut down, all right? Because ESO kept sending infiltrators into the school. And, you know, the Spirit came on Apostle Tahar right after 9/11 to shut down the school. And I think where we had the school, the people we were renting from, you know, after they demonized us on 9/11, they didn't want to rent to us anymore. All right. So really, they did us a favor. All right. So that was 1 Corinthians 3:9. Let me get another one. As a matter of fact, you know what? Jump down to the 16th verse, same chapter. 1 Corinthians 3:16. Know ye not that ye are the temple of the Heavenly Father? See? So we don't need a building. Know ye not that ye are the temple of the Heavenly Father, and the Spirit of the Heavenly Father dwelleth in you. So these bodies is the Heavenly Father's temple. Okay? These bodies that we're in. Let's get Acts. I think there's one in Acts 7:48. If I remember correctly. Acts 7:48. Howbeit, well, let me start at 47 verse. But Solomon built him an house. Howbeit, the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands, as saith the prophet. So you got a lot of these bootleg pastors. They pride themselves on getting a building so they could preach that nonsense. And if you check it out, right, they always have something called a priest fund. The priest fund is a bogus way for them to make, you know, get that money, get that bag. Because their guys like Geno Jennings, their main motivation is really money, filthy lucre. And scriptures speak about that. Every time you see this guy, he's dressed to the T, man. The scriptures tell you that the true prophets would wear what? They would wear sackcloth. Right? Sackcloth. So they wouldn't be looking all pretty. So that's another cut. Plus, they loathe poverty, you know. They loathe being poor. They'll tell you if you're poor, the Lord is not really with you. You're supposed to prosper. A lot of these phony pastors and preachers, Geno Jennings included, they teach the something called the prosperity doctrine. Meanwhile, Yahweh Shai was poor. Clearly, there's a scripture where it says he became poor. Even though he was rich, he became poor. Talking about Yahweh Shai. And the men, as a matter of fact, let me get that scripture for you. So that's a cold cut to it, that phony Hollywood freak, Geno Jennings. That's a cold cut, man. There it is right here. 2 Corinthians 8:9. For you know the grace of our Lord Yahweh Shai, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, that ye through his poverty might be rich. So again, most of these pastors, these preachers, they all strive to be rich. But here it is, the one who they claim they're worshiping, he became what? He became poor. All right? Can't get around this scripture. That ye, through his poverty, might be rich. Now, there's a scripture where it says, they despise the poor. Let's see if I can find that. Despise. I think it's in James. Is it James, the 5th chapter? Let me go to James. James, the 5th chapter. Or is it James, the 3rd chapter? Try the 2nd chapter. Yeah, this is it. James, the 2nd chapter. Start the first verse. By the way, this James was Yahawashi's biological brother. Okay. My brethren, have not the faith of our Lord Yahawashi, the Lord of glory, with respect of persons. For if they come unto your assembly a man with a gold ring in goodly apparel, and there come in also a poor man in vile remnant, and ye have respect to him that weareth the gay clothing, the goodly apparel, which shows you at one time the word gay meant happy. It had nothing to do with being a homosexual. There's one of many words that Esau has demonized, the word gay. Anyway, ye have respect to him that weareth the gay clothing, and say unto him, sit thou here in a good place. And say to the poor, stand thou there, or sit here under my footstool. Are ye not then partial in yourselves, and are become judges of evil thoughts? Now here's the point. In other words, not like the scriptures say, if you dress to the teeth, like they say, and you go to, let's say like Geno Jennings, his assembly, you know, you got to be decked out. He'll give you respect, you know, but if you came in there looking like a bum, he probably want to throw you out. All right. Like it says in the 4th verse, are ye not then partial in yourselves, and I'll become judges of evil thoughts? Now, here's the point. Hearken, my beloved brethren, have not the heavenly Father chosen the poor of this world, rich in faith? Now, that's in direct contrast to the doctrine that most of these churches teach. Churches like Geno Jennings, they teach the prosperity doctrine. Okay? They do not teach that one should be poor. You know, in other words, when I say poor, meaning having just enough daily bread, if you will. Isn't that what Yahawashi taught us when he taught us to pray? He said, give us this day our daily bread. And phone had to chime on that one, right? He said, give us this day our daily bread. In other words, we're going to have bread just enough for the day. You don't know about tomorrow. You don't know what tomorrow may bring. But these churches, they teach you to stock up and you know, get the poverty, you know, the become rich. There's a scripture in the book of Proverbs 23:9, which says this. Proverbs 23:9. Let's get that real quick. Is it 23 and 4? I'm sorry. Proverbs 23:4. Labor not to be rich. Cease from thine own wisdom. Now, again, that's what those wacky tacky churches teach you. They teach you to become rich. Carnally rich in this society. Okay? You know, the pastor sometimes when he gives his sermon, he'll talk about how his children are in college. You know? How he's living pretty good. And the people in the congregation envy him, especially the women. They envy him. They want to get with him. Okay? Labor not to be rich, cease from thine own wisdom. So that's a cold cut. Again, James 2:5, hearken, my beloved brethren, have not the Most High chosen the poor of this world, rich in faith, and heirs of the kingdom, which he hath promised to them that love him? But you, now here's the point, but you have despised the poor. See? You have despised the poor. Do not rich men oppress you and draw you before their judgment seats? So, these guys and their poverty doctrine, they despise the poor. Meanwhile, the Lord is looking for the poor. Let's get that in Isaiah 66 and 2. Isaiah 66 and 2. It says, "For all those things have mine hand made, and all those things have been, saith the Lord. But to this man will I look, even to him that is poor." In other words, you have just enough for your daily bread. That's what it means by poor. Doesn't mean a guy eating out of a garbage can. Okay? "Even to him that is poor, and of a contrite spirit, and trembleth at my word." So the Lord is dealing with the poor. Okay? But you'll never know that listening to these phony, wacky-tacky church, so-called church pastors, like Geno Jennings. All right, so back to Acts 7. Acts 7 and 48 again. "Howbeit, the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands, as saith the prophet." So that's another thing too, that we don't need a building. And a lot of these pastors, they get rich through that phantom building fund. The 49th verse, "Heaven is my throne and earth is my footstool. Where or what house will ye build me? See? They always have a building fund, right? They're trying to build a house of the Lord. We need a building fund to build the house of the Lord. In most cases, that's a scam. A big scam. "Heaven is my," Acts 7 and 49, "Heaven is my throne and earth is my footstool. What house will ye build me, saith the Lord? Or what is the place of my rest?" What's the answer to that? Our bodies. The Apostle Paul answered that when he wrote 1 Corinthians, the 3rd chapter, is the answer to that. The 9th verse, which says, "For we are laborers together with the Most High. Ye are the Most High's husbandry. Ye are the Most High's building." So you don't need no goddamn building fund. That's just a scam, man. All right. 16th verse. "Know ye not that ye are the temple of the Heavenly Father?" That's plain. "And that the Spirit of the Heavenly Father dwelleth in you." Okay. So let's get back to this.
You know, and the Lord ain't dealing with this guy.
Sure ain't.
The Lord is not dealing with this guy. How in the hell, matter of fact, let's go. Like I said, I'm not going to make this long. Anyway, let's go.
Now, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go to the brother, the Baltimore brother. Play a little bit of his video. And I'm getting ready to wrap this video up. Basically, I jumped to the topic of... Let me just play this video. And you'll hear what Geno Jennings say about the color of the Lord. And how it doesn't matter. And all that BS. But mind you, 4 years ago, he straight up taught that Jesus is not a white man. It lets you know the guy's a flip-flopper. You know, he's a... matter of fact, he's a double-minded man. What does the scripture say about that? Geno Jennings is a double-minded man. A double-minded man. The book of James 1 and 8, "A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways." So, you can't rely on Geno Jennings. That dude is unstable. It is right here. Now you see the title of this video. This was put up by Elder Karatzar of GMS Baltimore. Clearly you see the title, "Pastor Geno Jennings Say Jesus," because he doesn't say Yahushai. He says Jesus. "Jesus was black, but what do I care? Hebrews don't love Jesus." That's the title. So indirectly, what he's saying is Jesus is the one he calls Jesus is really a so-called white man. He believes that. He doesn't believe that the one he calls Jesus is a so-called black man. And that's another thing, too. We're not black. We're different shades of brown. And the name of the Son of the Lord is not Jesus. His name is Yahushai. Anyway, let's listen to this.
Can you hear me?
don't fear God. Prosperity, money.
You don't fear God. You don't even know his name. You don't know his name. You don't know his son's name. You're a joke. He says, God. There are many gods. The Lord said that us Israelites are gods. What is the true name of the Heavenly Father? What is the true name of your so-called God, huh? Do you even know? Let's bring out the scripture for those of you that are new. Proverbs 30 and 4. The name of the Heavenly Father and the name of his son is immensely important, man. And as a man of the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahshua, you're supposed to know the names of the Father and the Son. This is Proverbs 30 and 4. Who have ascended up into heaven or descended, who have gathered the wind in his fists, who have bound the waters in a garment, who have established all the ends of the earth. What is his name and what is his son's name, if thou canst tell? Can Geno Jennings tell? The answer is no. You know why? Because Yahweh Shem Yahshua is not dealing with him. He's a false pastor. He's a false apostle. Matter of fact, there are scriptures speak about false apostles. And the word apostle simply means sent away. That's all it means. Should come up now. Here we go. This is Geno Jennings' face should be right next to the scripture. The book of 2 Corinthians, the 11th chapter, the 13th verse. For such are false apostles, deceitful workers, transforming themselves into the apostles of Yahweh Shai. And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. There you go. And another point which Elder Apostle made, why is he directing that to us? As a matter of fact, you're going to hear him mention about the Hebrew Israelites. Let's go back and listen to this video.
Women, notoriety, popularity, all that took the place of God. God having...
That's what you're into, popularity and notoriety. Okay? That's why you dress the way you dress. They got that saying in the world, dress to impress, dress for success. And he looks like a cheap knockoff of the so-called white man. He got that suit, that shark skin suit. He got the tie. Come on, man. The true man of the Lord, the prophets, they didn't dress like that. You know, you go into the scriptures, it tells you how we were supposed to dress. We were supposed to wear a garment. The prophets wore garments down to the foot and the border of blue and the fringes at the bottom of the garment. Not no goddamn three-piece suit or two-piece suit.
Dwindle down right? To a paint.
Where'd he learn that shit? He learned that shit from the so-called white man, his slave master, his oppressor. All right? That's where he learned that from, to look like that while he claims he's representing the Heavenly Father and his son. This guy is a joke. What about the border of blue? What about the fringes? What about the long robe, the garment that the prophets are supposed to wear? The garment of sackcloth. The guy's a joke, man. He doesn't know the name of the Heavenly Father. He doesn't know the name of his son. He doesn't know his nationality. This guy is a big, fat joke.
Some little black or white Jesus.
And we're not black. The one you call Jesus, which that's not his name, he wasn't black. We are different shades of brown. I mean, this guy is so lost. It's not even funny.
On the wall, hanging on the cross.
Yeah, with that fake voice, man. Like I said, the actor Adolfo Caesar played a character like that in the movie Soldier Story.
So many Hebrew Israelites, and they say, you know,
you mentioned Hebrew Israelites.
All of them don't cuss me out, but a lot of them do, and I'm thankful for that.
He said he's like, it don't faze me. So if it don't faze you, why are you even mentioning it?
Some said I really enjoy that man.
That's right.
But why is it that man just won't say Jesus is black?
There's your answer.
Jesus was a Nazarene. And of course, Nazareth, of course, people was of color. All right. Jesus came out of a region of color. What's the big deal? What do I care if he was black? What's the big deal? What do I care if he was black?
Well, we care because, number one, you got a lie out there. You got a so-called white man Jesus. That's number one. So we care to prove that that's a lie. Also, that's called blasphemy of the Holy Spirit. How about that? Putting up so-called white man Jesus is blasphemy of the Holy Spirit. And it's in the scriptures. If you go in the book of Job, he said, what do I care? It shows you this guy. Heavenly Father, his name Yahweh, and his son's name is Yahweh Shai, I haven't sent that dude. Job 9 and 24, he says, what do I care? Job 9 and 24, it says this, the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. Yeah, who's the wicked? Esau, Edom. And during something called iconoclasm, that's where that image pretty much came out of, that so-called white man image. It really goes back to Serapis Christus. All right, Serapis Christus, which was a so-called white man god that told me the first setup. That's where the origin, if for those of you that don't know, the origin of so-called white man Jesus really goes back to Serapis Christus when you do the research. And that was a so-called white god that told me the first setup. Okay, so that's an example of covering the face of the real judge, which the real judge is a so-called black man, a man of color, a very dark-skinned man, like it tells us in Revelation, the first chapter. He says he doesn't care, but meanwhile, the appearance of the Lord is in the book of Revelation, the first chapter, the 13th going into the 15th verse. So I guess he doesn't care about the truth. Anyway, the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. Yeah, by putting up his face. He covered the face, the real face, which those faces are so-called black people, people of color. Hence, you had something called iconoclasm, right? The destruction or the defacing of the dark art that was left during the Dark Ages, which it was so-called black man ruling, okay? He covered the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? See? So it does matter. Let's get the book of, John 7 and 38. It doesn't matter to Genogenes because he's a liar. And the Holy Spirit's not dealing with him. And he is not a man of the Heavenly Father, neither his son. The Heavenly Father have not sent him. John 7 and 38. He that believeth on me, as the scripture have said. Now the scriptures have plenty to say what the Lord looks like, what the Son of the Lord look like. You go in Daniel 7 and 9, Daniel 10, 5 and 6, Revelation 1, 13 to 14. The scriptures got plenty to say on what the Heavenly Father and the Son looks like. Because the Heavenly Father and the Son knew that in the latter times Esau would come into power. Esau being the wicked, that is. And one of the things they would do as the wicked is cover the true faces of the Heavenly Father and the Son and the angels. Okay? So this is why it is written, he that believeth on me, as the scripture have said, out of his belly, meaning his mind, shall flow rivers of living water, the truth. So you have to believe, those of you who claim you believe, you have to believe in the Heavenly Father and the Son according to what the scripture have said. And I just gave you plenty of examples of scriptures, plenty of examples of scriptures that tell you what the Heavenly Father looked like, what his Son looked like. So once again, Genogenes is a fake. He's a phony.
What's the big deal?
What's the big deal is the truth. What is the truth? What did the Heavenly Father look like? What did his Son look like? Because it's right there in the Bible. And if it didn't matter, why is it in the Bible? And it sure enough mattered to the so-called white man because he took down our true images and put up his image. There's a saying, image is everything. He couldn't very well rule with our image being on top. No, he had to take down our image and put up his image. Okay? So this guy is a clown, man. That's why I said earlier, he's a Hollywood freak show.
Right? Yes, I do know he was not a European. He came from a region where people was of color, like I am. But why I don't preach about that? Because his skin color was never a topic of interest.
Then why is it in the Bible? If it's not a topic of interest, Geno Jennings, why are there three scriptures speaking about the appearance of the Lord? Well, start with the Heavenly Father and then His Son. Why? Daniel 7 and 9, Daniel 10, 5 and 6, Revelation 1, 13 to 14. Then you have the appearance of the Israelites in the scriptures. Okay? You had certain men like... there's a scripture where it speaks about Barnabas and Simeon. Simeon, who was called Niger. You look up the word Niger, it means so-called black. So Simeon that ministered right along with Barnabas, he had to be a very dark-skinned man. Hence the reason why they called him Niger. You can read that in Acts the 13th chapter. So once again, you're seeing that Geno Jennings is a fraud. He's a phony.
To the apostles or the prophets.
Yeah, because they themselves were men of color. But the point is, why is it in the Bible? That's the point.
Jesus was my complexion or Dan complexion.
And I believe he said, if Jesus was my complexion. Why you got to say if? So he's so in doubt. Now, if you a true man of the Lord would straight up tell you what the Heavenly Father looks like and what His Son looks like and give you the scriptures to prove it.
We can get out of it. Hear me, human family. The black Jesus, His blackness don't mean nothing.
He wasn't black. He was brown. And again, if it don't mean nothing, why is it the appearance of the one you call Jesus, which his name is Yahweh Shai, is in the book of Revelation, the first chapter, beginning at the 13th verse, speaking about his hair like the pure wool, speaking about the color of his skin like burnt brass. Again, if it doesn't matter, it don't mean nothing, why is it in the Bible? So at this point, you can see that this guy is not about the scriptures. Let's get John 3 and 34, and we're going to wrap it up. I made the point. John 3 and 34. It says this, for he whom the Heavenly Father have sent speaketh the words of the Heavenly Father, as in the scriptures. You'll notice everything I say, and this is how we were taught at 1 West 125th Street by our elders. Everything we say to be justified, they got to come out the scriptures. Everything we say. That's why we're constantly going back to the scripture where it was said. So you people out there, You brothers as well as you sisters that believe in this truth, you can learn these scriptures. Okay? John 3 and 34, for he whom the Heavenly Father have sent speaketh the words of the Heavenly Father, for the Heavenly Father giveth not the Spirit by measure unto him. And that's a demonstration of the Holy Spirit, the fact that we can bring out these scriptures like that. The Holy Spirit tells us what to say. Just like the Heavenly Father Yahweh told Moses, I will be with your mouth and your brother's mouth and tell you what to say. How about that? Isaiah 8 and 20, let's read that. It says, to the law and to the testimony, what's the law and the testimony? These scriptures. From the Old Testament to the New Testament, the whole book. Clearly it is written, the Son of the Heavenly Father, he said, I come in the volume of the book. That's in two scriptures, Hebrews 10 and 7, Psalms 40 and 7. To the law and to the testimony, if they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no light in them. And here's your exhibit A. All right?
That's right.
Here's your exhibit A right there. He doesn't speak according to this word. He speaks according to his own thoughts and feelings. That's why he said the color of the one he calls Jesus doesn't matter. But meanwhile, it's in the Bible. Anyway, I'm done with this guy. Hopefully you were edified. you brothers and you few sisters out there, especially those of you that are new. If you were edified and you're new to this, drop me a line in the comment section, all right? So for now, I say Shalom.